Welcome back to the 9th standard social classes. My dear student, in this class we are going to deal with the one of the important points from the lesson Vijayanagara and Bahamani Kingdom. The most important aspects from the lesson, that is art and architecture. Dear student, in this class we are going to deal with the contribution of Vijayanagara Empire to the field of art and architecture. This is the point we are going to deal with in this class. Before going to start today's class, let us class once again what we had a great discussion in the last class. Dear student, in the last class, we discussed many contributions that were given by Vijayanagara Empire to the field of administration, social system, economical system, and the cultural aspects, how the festivals were being celebrated in Vijayanagara Empire, and also how the agricultural field had reached to the pinnacle of glory in the time of Vijayanagara Empire. These were the things what we discussed in the last class. I hope that you studied very well in the last class. And now, let us go how Vijayanagara Empire gave contribution to the art and architectural field. My dear student, the excellent work done by Vijayanagara kings, the excellent works done by Vijayanagara king, yes, it is proven that when we go to Vijayanagara Empire's capital city, Hampi, yes, you will get all the information how the structures of buildings were built and how the temples were built, how the mosques were built, how Jaina Basadis were built, and also the temples of Sri Vaishnavism, and some temples were belong to Veerashaivism. These can be seen when we visit to the areas who ruled Vijayanagara Empire. It is actually excellent work done by Vijayanagara kings. In the field of art and architectural, especially, it is very memorable. It is very memorable. The emperors from the Vijayanagara Empire were known as great pattern of architecture. Dear students, most of the kings from Vijayanagara Empire who ruled on the name of all the four dynasties were called as great patronize to the art and architectural field. And also, these kings were great patronize to the literature also. During the period of all the kings, during the period of this Vijayanagara Empire, during the time of 300 years or 3 centuries, many temples were built, many palaces were built, and many forts were built, towers were built, huge halls or Mahamandapas were also built. Then public buildings, marriage hall, tanks, buds, canals, and many dams which would help to agricultural activities. So for that these kings increased agricultural activities also. So these were the important aspects that Vijayanagara Empire gave more importance to the art and architecture. Along with that, so let us see the unique future of. So what is the unique future of Vijayanagara kingdom, especially when we come to the part of art and architectural style? Dear student, Vijayanagara Empire had its own unique future. Wherever they wanted to construct or build any kind of building, it must have its own style. that is called unique features of Vijayanagara art. So what is the unique feature of Vijayanagara art? Let us see. What is that? Unique features. Unique features of Vijayanagara. What is that? Unique feature of Vijayanagara art. It has its own structural design. It has its own characteristics. So what characteristics that Vijayanagara Empire's architectural style had? Dear student, you might have observed whenever you go to Hampi, a very interesting and very structural design style. Vijayanagara king continued to architectural style of Chalukyas. Who? Chalukyas. Chalukyas architectural style was followed by Vijayanagara Empire. And also Cholas and Hoysalas. See, these are the unique features of Vijayanagara Empire's architectural style and art. The unique feature of their architecture was the construction of what would be the unique structure? And what would be the characteristics of a temple or mosque or marriage hall or big building like that? See, whenever you enter into the structure which come under Vijayanagara Empire, we will have the construction of Hughes Auditorium. We will get the Hughes Auditorium and marriage hall, temples and Hughes towers. These towers were called as, how these were called? Yes, Raya Gopuras. These huge towers were called as Raya Gopuras and leaf shaped arches could be seen in this time, and also platforms, huge platforms could be seen during the time of Vijayanagara Empire. And along with that, in this type of art, modern ornamentation, the qualities of grandeur. Modern ornamentation, we could see the grandeur quality and the awesome creature and elegance were given importance. Nothing but here we cannot see more ornamental style, but we could see only the qualities of a grandeur and creation of some awe and elegance. These were very important in this unique feature. And then rough granite stone was used for the more temples construction in these time. Dear students, many kings were used rough granite stone. We can also call this Kanashile in Kannada. So this kind of stone was used in the construction of temples and buildings and structure. Then, during the time of Vijayanagara kings, temples built in many places of Karnataka, not only Karnataka, many places in the southern part of India. See, like how and where, yes, Hampi, very best place Hampi, and one of the pilgrimage centers in Karnataka, that is Sringeri, Tirupati, and then Lepakshi, Karkala, Moodbidre, Bhatkala, and Chidambaram, Kanchi, Kalahasti, Nandi, Srishaila, Kolara, and other places. We can see these kind of structural monuments or buildings in the from the Vijayanagara period. Along with that, the most important temple constructed during the time of Vijayanagara Empire, that is none other than, yes, Vidyashankara temple. Yes, very very important temple that was constructed during the time of Vijayanagara Empire, that is Vidyashankara temple. It is situated at Sringeri. Where is that? Sringeri in Shivamogga district. Got it? And then The structure of this temple, the structure of this Vidyashankara temple is unique not only in India but also entire India. Not only in Karnataka but also entire in India. And then the most ancient temple which was constructed during the time of Vijayanagara Empire, that is none other than Virupaksha temple, which was built at Hampi. And having a vast courtyard in Virupaksha temple, we can see the vast courtyard or hall. This temple has many pillars with sculptures and decorative ceiling. Yesterday, if you enter into the Virupaksha temple, you will get the beauty and grandeur of the temple, like many pillars with the sculptures and decorative ceiling can be seen if you visit to the temple of Virupaksha, which is in Vijayanagara Empire or in Hampi. Then Vidyavitala temple of Hampi is known for its magnificent architectural beauty. Then the Saptaswara musical pillar can also see in this time. Saptaswara musical temples and pillars, huge Kalyana Mantapa and the stone chariot. Dear student, very very attractive one in Hampi, that is a single stone chariot can be seen in Hampi, have enhanced the beauty of the temple. All these structures enhance the beauty of the temple. And then along with that, my dear student, the Dasara festival was also celebrated during this Vijayanagara time, celebrated on Mahanavami platform. See, Dasara festival was celebrated on the Mahanavami platform constructed by Krishna Devaraya, and many visitors from foreign and other reasons were used to visit to the Dasara festivals. The ambassador of Persia, Abdul Razak is the ambassador from Persia, recorded that during the festival, kings from distant places and provincial leaders used to assemble as per the orders of the emperors or kings of the Vijayanagara Empire. Dear friends, it shows that visiting of kings from very distant places shows that how Dasara festival was celebrated on Mahanavami Mandap during the time of Vijayanagara Empire. Yes, it shows the beauty and prosperity of Vijayanagara Empire. And many ambassadors used to, and provincial officers also used to visit to the festival. Then along with that, Kamala Mahal, Elephant Stable, Queen's Bath are wonderful example of Indo-Muslim architectural style. Dear students, very important, and Indo-Muslim architectural styles buildings were Kamala Mahal, Elephant Stable and Queen's Bath are very 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 beautiful example for the Indo-Islamic architectural style. Then along with that, we can also say that if you visit to Hampi, you will see all the elephant gallery or elephant stable and Queen's Bath, and everything can be seen if you go to Hampi. And then Lakshmi Narasimha, Kadale Kalo Ganesha and Sasavi Kalo Ganesha stone, and then a stone chariot and Uddhana Veerabhadra idols are attractive monuments in this structure. Dear students, these are the very attractive things in Hampi. We can also, I will repeat once again. Yes, Lakshmi Narasimha temple can be seen, Kadale Kalo Ganesha temple also seen, and then Sasavi Kalo Ganesha temple can be seen, and very important that single stone chariot, along with that Uddhana Veerabhadra Swami idols can be seen, and these are the very attractive aspects in the time of Vijayanagara Empire. The fort of Hampi during Vijayanagara Empire was very strong with seven circular walls around it. Yes, the palace of Vijayanagara Empire, the Hampi Palace, was constructed and it was surrounded by a strong seven circular walls. Isn't it? So it is very attractive in Vijayanagara time. Dear student, along with that, at present these are only four circular walls. Dear students, at present there are four circular walls can be seen around the temples or fort. Now, so now it is ruined, as I told, as a result of Shahi kingdom's attack. The result of Shahi kingdom's attack, now the Hampi is present completely ruined. What is that? Completely ruined. I hope that you understood very well about Vijayanagara Empire, how the rulers ruled and how various field called social development, economical development and cultural development and art and architectural development were developed during the time of Vijayanagara's kings. I hope that you understood very well. Now, dear students, I hope that you understood about the Vijayanagara Empire, how it was ruled. Then here, now, another one contemporary of Vijayanagara Empire, that is Bahamani Kingdom or Bahamani Empire. Dear student, Vijayanagara Empire ruled South India, especially the two kingdoms were ruled South India. Here, these two kingdoms were contemporary rulers or contemporary kingdoms, and they established in the same time or the same century. Dear student, the other important historical change seen in the 14th century, my dear student, Vijayanagara Empire was founded in 1336 CE. Got it? Whereas Bahamani Kingdom was started in 1347 CE. See, these two kingdoms were called as contemporary kingdoms. And we can also change very important change during the time of 14th century. See, it was none other than the rise of Bahamani Kingdom. The rise of Bahamani Kingdom. In the year 1347 era, who established this kingdom? Very good. Alauddin Hasan Gangu Bahman Shah. Who is that? Alauddin Hasan Gangu Bahman Shah. See, as it is so long name, he is the founder of Bahamani Kingdom in the time of 1347 CE. Who is the founder? Alauddin Hasan Gangu Bahman Shah. He established this dynasty. And then the Bahamani and the Shahi dynasties ruled from 1347 to 1686. 1347 to 1686. They ruled Bahamani Kingdom and Shahi dynasties ruled up to 1686 CE. See, among their rulers, Muhammad Shah I. Among the rulers of Bahamani Kingdom, Muhammad Shah I Mahmud Shah II, Firoz Shah, Yusuf Adil Khan, or Yusuf Adil Khan, Ibrahim Adil Shah I, Ibrahim Adil Shah II, or the important rulers and the most important rulers in the kingdom. And when we go on studying about Bahmani kingdom, the history of Bahmani rulers can be seen at two stages. In the first stage, that is during the time of 1346 to 1422 CE, that is the first stage of Bahmani kings and their ruling time. Gulbarga was the capital. It was the capital. Gulbarga was the capital city of Bahmani kings. Where is Vijayanagara's capital? Is Hampi. Yes, there are main rivals were Rayas of Telangana. Who is that? Rayas of Telangana were the main rivals, and under the Rayas of Telangana and Vijayanagara, these are both. 8 sultans ruled from here. How many sultans ruled from here? 8 sultans ruled from here. Got it? Among them, Shihabuddin Ahmad shifted the capital from Gulbarga to Bidar. Who shifted the capital from Gulbarga to Bidar? Shihabuddin Ahmad shifted the capital city from Gulbarga to Bidar. Got it? Then, Bidar remained the capital city of Bahmani till their end. Bidar became or remained as the capital city of Bahmani sultans of Bahmani kingdom. See, then Muhammad Gawan. Let us see the Muhammad Gawan, how he ruled. Who is that? Muhammad Gawan. Dear student, the time of his ruling is, Muhammad Gawan's ruling time was 1347 to, how much? 1411 to 1411 CE to 1481. This is the ruling time of Muhammad Gawan. See, from 1347 to 1426 common era, Kalburgi was the capital of Bahmani kingdoms. During this period, Muhammad Gawan ruled the kingdom from the same capital city with selflessness. So without any selfishness, he ruled, and he had a great dedication about his kingdom. As a prime minister, Muhammad Gawan, as a prime minister, he took the Bahmani kingdom to the great heights. Dear students, as a prime minister, Muhammad Gawan took the entire kingdom to the optimum level. He learned the Muslim religions, verses, literature, and law at Cairo. He learned Muslim religious verses, literature, and law at Cairo. Also gained proficiency in Arab and Parsi language. Dear student, Muhammad Gawan learned proficiency in two languages, that is Arab and Parsi languages. He learned Islam religious verses, literature, and law. So these things helped him to rule in good manner in his administrative time. He served as a prime minister during the rule of Bahmani King Humayun, Nizam Shah, and Muhammad Shah III. He served as prime minister under the kings of Bahmani kings like Humayun, Nizam Shah, and Muhammad Shah III. And he contributed many things to the kingdom as a prime minister. When we go on studying about Muhammad Gawan, we will get more information about Muhammad Gawan. Among them, my dear pupil, he was responsible for the entire kingdom and enhancing the glory of Bahmani kingdom by his efficient administration and victories. Gawan, Muhammad Gawan, conquered many places like Konkan, Belagavi, Goa, and later he invaded Orissa and conquered Kondavidu and merged to his Bahmani kingdom. Basically, he was a great warrior and he learnt many languages and also was a kind-hearted too. In the year 1481, remember this year, in the year 1481, he invaded Kanchi, which is there in Tamil Nadu at present, Kanchi, and plundered its huge wealth. Dear student, in the year 1481, he attacked on Kanchi or Kanchi and plundered heavy wealth from Kanchi or Kanchi, which is there in Tamil Nadu. Thus, Muhammad Gawan, who was responsible for the all-round development of the Bahmani kingdom. Yes, he was the responsible of all-round development of Bahmani dynasty or Bahmani kingdom. Then, he became a victim to a conspiracy of his enemies and was beheaded on the false charge of betrayal to the kingdom. Dear student, after the death of Muhammad Gawan, the entire kingdom became very weak, because after the ruling of the death of Muhammad Gawan, we couldn't see any proper kings or able king. So for this reason, and also we could see some disintegrated into five parts. The entire kingdom disintegrated into five parts after the death of Muhammad Gawan. And then after the death of Muhammad Gawan, the entire kingdom became five integrated parts. And then next one, the next warrior is none other than Ibrahim Adil Shah. Who is that? Ibrahim Adil Shah. Now let us see more detail about Ibrahim Adil Shah. The most important king of Adil Shahi, that is Ibrahim II, ascended the throne in the his only 9 year. Yes, when he was at the 9 year, he ascended the throne. Who is that? Ibrahim Adil Shah. Ibrahim Adil Shah. Dear student, Ibrahim Adil Shah, who ascended the throne, at that time he was just 9 years old, and he ruled over 47 years. Yes, how long he ruled? 47 years he ruled, with some historic incidents. Politically, he took Vijayanagara to the pinnacle of glory with his efficient administrative skill and was responsible for the tremendous progress in art, literature and education. The student Ibrahim Adil Shah II, he was a person who caused to development of Vijayanagara Empire in art, literature and education, and he took the entire Vijayanagara Empire to the pinnacle of glory in his time. And also, it reached the optimum level during the time of Ibrahim II. You see, his book, Kitab-e-Nawras, he wrote the book, that is Kitab-e-Nawras. Kitab-e-Nawras. My dear pupil, observe here. Kitab-e-Nawras was written by Ibrahim II. It begins, the book begins with the praise of the gods Ganesha. Very interesting matter. Dear student, he is belong to Islam religion, got it? Though he is belong to Islam religion, he wrote a book, Kitab-e-Navras, which starts from the prayer of Hindu god Ganesha. Think about that, how he was a religious tolerance. Got it? And also, we can also see the prayer of Saraswati and Narasimha Swami. There are prayers to Muhammad Paigambar too. There we can see the prayer of Muhammad Paigambar too in the book. This book is the real evidence of the knowledge, magnanimity and religious tolerance of Ibrahim Ali Shah. Got it? It is the evidence of religious tolerance of Ibrahim II. Then, see cultural contributions of Bahmani Sultans. See, what were the cultural contributions of the Bahmani Sultans to the kingdom? The Bahmani and the Shahi Sultans ruled over Karnataka for almost 200 years. Yes, sure, it's about 200 years this Bahmani and Sultans, Adi Shahi Sultans ruled. In addition to Karnataka, they extended their kingdom up to Thanjavur, which is there in Tamil Nadu. They extended their kingdom from Karnataka to Thanjavur or Tamil Nadu. They had organized their administration based on Islamic religious principles. Then there were three administrative schemes. So how the administration was during the time of Bahmani? Let us see the administration. How the administration was? My dear pupil, there were three levels of administration, namely central, provincial government and village government. Among these, ivugalalli, there was a revenue department, judicial department and a military department could be seen in the administration of Bahmani time. The Sultan was the chief of a central administrative system. The cabinet was called Majlis-e-Ilvit. There was also a cabinet, it was called as Majlis-e-Ilvit. And top officials, commanders, ulemas and amins were friends and relatives of the Sultan. Then when we come to the administrative matter, Muhammad Gawan converted the existing four tarafs or provinces into 8 units, and these 8 15 sarkars. The Subedar was the administrator in each of these sarkars. Sarkars were divided into again paraganas. Kotwal, Deshmukh and Desai was the administrator of the paraganas. Then the final unit of the administration of the time, that is village unit. Village unit having a Patel, Kulkarni and guards as staff. These could be seen in village level administrative unit. The village units were the independent unit. And now the revenue of Vijayanagara Empire. My dear students, I hope that you understood about all these aspects of today's class. And remaining part, that is the revenue system, military system and judicial system, will be discussed in the next class. Until then, take care, study well and do the notes, listen the class carefully and be safe at your home. Until then, take care, bye.